Hi there, just a bit of fun today. I'm combining a couple of different ideas. I've had quite a few people asking me, what do you mean by this kind of cohesiveness thing about the sound of the strings in the BBC Symphony Orchestra plugin, as compared to, for example, our symphonic strings library? And it occurred to me that as it's 10 years since we recorded the Bespoke Symphonic Strings, it might be kind of fun to look at the three things side by side. So just pick out a few patches from the Bespoke Symphonic Strings, from the Symphonic Strings in the SSO, in the Spitfire Symphony Orchestra library, and then the BBC Symphonic String section in the BBC Symphony Orchestra plugin, and see what their differences are. So first things first, let's have a quick look at the mics and stuff that I'm using here. So I've got the CTAO patches up for the symphonic strings, and also kind of using the same mics in the BBC Symphony Orchestra plugin. And the reason for that being that on the old Bespoke library, there basically aren't any mic options. It's a super lo-fi contact patch. And it just had a mix that we put together, and that was just the mix. But it does have the outriggers in, it's got a bit of close in, all that kind of stuff. So let's have a quick look then and see, and we'll look at these shorts first so you can get a feel for the comparison of the ambience of the rooms. Now, this is a significant thing because the scoring stage sound of the of Maida Vale, where the BBC Symphony Orchestra plugin was recorded, is it's a fantastic room. It's very much less reverberant than air. So let's just jump straight in and have a quick listen. So on BBCSO, cellos, spiccato. So that gives you a quick idea. I haven't altered any of the tightness settings or anything like this. Here is the symphonic strings. Just switch to record on that. Okay, and then finally switching over to the Bespoke. Okay, so yeah, it's a little bit choppy at the beginning of the notes there, unfortunately. The way that we recorded that was kind of experimental. We used a kind of sequence of notes and then used the last one, which from a performance perspective worked great, but it did mean that there was still enough room sound ringing when you cut into the beginning of the sample that, you know, wasn't kind of ideal. But then going back to the symphonic strings, so you can hear kind of similar ambience, a little bit more control, a little bit more refined, and then going back to the BBC. And you can obviously tighten this up if you want to get that kind of slightly tighter sound that we've got in the other two libraries. So that's kind of interesting. What about the long notes? So we're going to make it a fair fight, just pull that back down again. We'll just look at the longs. So let's load those up from both libraries. I'll try and match the mix as well, so that we get a kind of as good a comparison as possible. Now I'm going to put vibrato on here. This is a key switch between non-vib and vib on the old Bespokes. That looks about right. We've got the same mic setup again here. Okay, so let's start with the Bespoke library. So we might need to turn this one up a little bit just to get a kind of comparison of sound. Thank you. Okay, let's move across to symphonic strings. That's a mod. That's the vibrato level at the top. So let's get a fairer comparison with the vibrato right in the middle. Okay, quite nice. Let's switch across to the BBC. Oh, so vibrato, a little bit loud this is. Let's pull that down. Actually, just pull that down here. Okay, and then mod wheel for dynamic. And I'm just going to switch this across to vibrato so you can see what I'm doing here. Put that in the middle. Okay, just jumping back across to symphonics. And then bespoke. So it's interesting, and I think, you know, it's part. It's two things here. It's the room, but it's also the kind of ensemble of the players. And with the with these two groups, the session bands in these two, the bespoke and the Spitfire Symphonic Strings, you can hear the kind of individual players seem slightly more separated from each other. And if we go back to the BBC. It seems more blended somehow. Now we can try and add in, if we want to get that kind of sound, if we want to get that slightly more individualistic, let's hear a few players in there. If I add in the leader mic. You can hear there that you're getting a little bit more of the sound of an individual player in there. So with that, you do hear a little bit more there. And I would probably go so far as to change the balance of the other mics as well. So let's pull these things down a little bit. Maybe we'd go heavier on the outriggers because of the difference in the overall room. See what that sounds like. Interesting. Okay, let's jump across to the violins and have a listen to those. See how those compare. Okay, so I'm going to do my same thing. I'm going to switch the mix off. I'm going to put up my close, tree, outriggers, and yeah, a bit of ambience. Let's jump across to here and load up violins from here. Try and match as much as I can. So let's pull vibrato to the middle, and then let's nip back up here and look at the longs. Where are they? V1 longs. And again, we'll do vibrato, like key switch there. Okay, right, let's have a listen. Okay, bespoke first up. Okay. Spitfire Symphonic Strings. I'm going to put the vibrato back up a little bit. Okay, so let us check out a bit of the, just put the vibrato up, so we're matching the vibrato. Let's check out a bit of the BBC Symphony Orchestra up here first. Okay, let's go to Spitfire Symphonic Strings. Okay, and let's check out the bespokes. Interesting. I mean, the obvious difference really is the ambience, but we can get the huge advantage of having all of these mics is that we can change what we're hearing here. If we go for something slightly different, let's put in the leader. Gonna add in the sides, and let's put a bit of the spill mix in, the full spill. Just a little bit, and see what that sounds like. Interesting. Let's push that right up. Maybe a touch of balcony. Already going slightly mad here. Got a huge number of mics open, but let's see what it sounds like. Nice. So now I've added in a bit of depth of the room, going back and comparing it. It's very interesting. I mean, it's so hard to separate them in terms of the space that they're recorded in, obviously. The spaces are so different. Air is so much more of a reverberant space. But just trying to get a kind of match, All great sounds. Let us check out, let's play some chords with the strings, with violins, down the bottom end here, and maybe kind of mid volume. So here's the bespoke. Okay, let's switch across to symphonics. There's a lot more vibrato in that, isn't there? Let's pull that down a bit. Okay, interesting. Let's nip back over to the BBC. We're probably a little bit less vibrato. Interesting, and let's just, out of interest, let's pull out all of these mics and go back to our mix. So we'll just put mix one up. And just out of interest, as an alternative, here's mix two. Symphonics. Interesting. Yeah, that's very interesting. They're different, as you'd expect, I guess. They sound very different. I wonder, actually, let's try. We have got one mic in absolute common here, which is the tree. We can compare that certainly between the there we go. We can compare that between symphonic strings and the BBCSO, and that will actually give you quite a clear idea of the room as well. But listening to that on symphonics. And on the BBC. and then just going back to spiccato on both of these. Wrong library. 1 second. Okay, so just the tree on there. Let's see what we've got for violin shorts here. Okay, so yeah, starts a little bit crunchy. Symphonics. BBCSO. Interesting. Okay, let's compare the basses. So, symphonic strings here. Jump out of their basses. Let's look at the longs. Why not? Pretty sure this is the same number of players. Let's leave it on. Actually, I'm going to put my little mix up. But I'm just going to use close and outriggers. Not 100% sure what we used here. But it's going to be a very similar setup because of the because obviously it was Jake recording it, and it was kind of the normal kind of setup. So I think probably we recorded the tree with the outriggers mixed into it, and the close and ambient. I think we probably did that. So just out of interest, let's have a listen to the shorts here. Okay, and oops, I've loaded up longs. 1 second. Short spiccato. Okay. Let's leave the tree in, actually. Try and match the mix. Okay. I think that sounds pretty similar. Let's just quickly nip over to the BBC and I'll match up the mix here as well. I'm just going to quickly remove a few of these that I'm not going to use. It'll be quite fun to check out the pizzicatos, actually. Let's just leave those in and we'll get rid of everything else. Okay, so back to our mics. Okay, let's go check those out. Yeah, definite big difference here is the room, obviously. Yeah, that's kind of lacking 3D space really for me a little bit now. Now that we've kind of got used to the ability to have all of these mics. Okay, and then BBC. Okay, pizzicatos. Pizzicatos. Match the mix up again. Is that right? Yeah, I think that's what we had. Okay. Pits is here with the bespoke. Okay, jump back to BBCSO. And symphonics. Interesting. Okay, and let's just check out our long notes. So, where are they? Longs, bang in the middle. There we go. Symphonics. Lodi, lodi. Where are you? Long, CTAO. BBC, long. Next day's the same. All good. Okay, so. So that's the bespokes. Symphonics. BBC. Interesting. Let's take out the close and outriggers and just listen to the tree. Okay, and symphonics, just the tree. And can't really compare properly here, but hang on, it's not happy. Oh, that's weird. Let's just reload that. Oh, I know what's happened. That was another experiment. Okay, ignore that. Quick flick back. And BBC. Okay, I mean, obviously, the big difference is that they're recorded in different rooms. And the other big difference is that you have two different styles of playing. You've got the session band style of playing where you can hear, you know, the individuals within the section a little more easily. And then with the BBC Symphony Orchestra, you've got a very symphonic style of playing where there's a huge emphasis on blend of the section and producing a different kind of sound. Both amazing, great sounds. It's very interesting to hear them kind of next to each other and to be able to compare the two different things. So there we go. So it's a quick look at the three different things. If anybody is even vaguely interested in this, then just let me know in the comments below. And I'll load up some other stuff and where we'll have a look at the woods and at the brass and things like that as well. So I hope that was interesting. If you enjoyed that, and ding the bell, subscribe if you haven't already. I'm going to keep putting up more stuff. I'm also working on the next section of the kind of arranging or voicing your parts within the BBC Symphony Orchestra plugin. So that'll be coming soon as well. So see you on the next one. Bye-bye.